This video is sponsored by Squarespace.
What that is that, like, you know, no matter how anyone is, like, born, like, whatever, like, anyone's, like, physical appearance is, right? Like, there's only so much you can do with this. But one thing that you do have power over, but you have to work at it, is confidence. And, like, confidence is sexy. And, like, knowing who you are is sexy. You're such a sweet guy. And you do have a lot to offer. But if you don't make it seem like you know that you have a lot to offer, like, no one else is going to really, like, give you the time of day.
Right.
Does my hair look insane?
Yes.
Yeah, it does.
It does.
But it's fierce, so I don't care.
I, like most people, have always looked at reality TV as being mindless media. It's content that you can put on and most of the time not walk away with anything beneficial. It's rare that I ever seem to find a significant amount of substance through reality television. That is, until I decided to join the bandwagon and watch Queer Eye. If you're somehow unaware, Queer Eye is a show where five gay guys, aka the Fab Five, make over straight guys who need it. Bobby deals with design, Karamo deals with culture, Tan with fashion, my sweet baby boy Anthony deals with food, and last but not least, Jonathan deals with grooming. From the first episode, You Can't Fix Ugly, it's evident that this isn't a completely mindless reality show. Queer Eye is about more than just providing an entertaining and easy-to-watch experience. It's about self-care and becoming a better you. While I definitely see each member of the Fab Five as being critical to what makes the show so special, there's one member in particular that stands out to me as being incredibly overlooked, and that's Jonathan Van Ness.
Can you believe?
No.
You're probably thinking, oh, but Karsten Jonathan is clearly the fan favorite. He has the most followers on Instagram. He is anything but overlooked. Sure, from a popularity standpoint, Jonathan is far from underrated, but I feel as though he is without a doubt the most essential member of the group. There's much to address, so without any further ado, I'm going to dive into what makes Jonathan Van Ness the best member of Queer Eye. As we all know, Jonathan slays at grooming. We can all argue who does their specialty best. In my opinion, it's obviously Jonathan, but that's not what I'm here to talk about. I'm here to talk about the importance of grooming and how that is arguably the most important aspect of the process. For one, grooming is relatively simple, affordable, and easy to remember as opposed to the others. Designing a home is expensive, nice clothes cost money, and I love my sweet angel Anthony, but do you think any of the contestants are going to make these dishes? Jonathan recommends like three or so products to use that are easy to remember, easy to use, affordable, and make the contestants excited to use them. That's only half of why I see grooming as so important though. A common theme in most contestants in Queer Eye is protectiveness. They are usually very protective of their space, and what bigger space to be protective about than your body. With the other members of the Fab Five, a contestant simply has to agree and say, yeah, I can do that, I can do this, whatever. One could argue Bobby is an exception because he literally changes their entire living space, but that doesn't nearly seem as personal as Jonathan. Contestants gain a sense of trust and connection with Jonathan by allowing him to literally take control of their faces. By doing so, I feel Jonathan more than any other member is able to truly bring the contestant out of their shell, which leads me into my next point. It can be argued that Karamo Brown is the true mind behind addressing mental health and character on the show, and it's true. Karamo is amazing at what he does, he clearly knows his stuff, and he manages to get certain information and perspectives out of the contestants that is crucial for the sake of their growth. Oh, and not to mention his smile, I mean, Jesus! But something I feel the other members, including Karamo, fail to find in the contestants is the human within them. I'm no mental health expert, I'm studying film, but it doesn't take much to understand that growing as a person, learning how to self-improve, is impossible if there's a lack of self-knowledge. What I think makes Jonathan Van Ness so special is his ability to take this a step further by not only helping contestants realize who they are, but bringing that personality out. Whereas before I talked about how Jonathan is able to bring them out of their shells physically, here I want to address how he does so mentally. It's hard to make this sound pretentious or deep, so I'm just going to come right out and say it. Jonathan is just a fun and goofy guy. That's really all it is. Again, Karamo is amazing, but he is also more on the serious side when he has to do his job, and rightfully so. To get serious answers, he needs to be a serious person. But I think the other half of this job is bringing someone out of a shell and creating a comfortable and fun space, and I think no member is better at doing this than Jonathan. Whether it be an uncomfortable hug, playing with hair, trying on clothes, or cracking jokes.
If you accidentally knock your wife up, you have to name the baby Jonathan, because it's totally my fault because I got you this haircut.
That'd be funny.
Jonathan manages to create an open and inviting space by automatically making himself the most extra in the room. By doing so, everyone naturally channels that energy and feels more comfortable bringing out their own personalities now that the bar is so ridiculously high. As a result, you get something as beautifully simple as a shy contestant cracking a joke, which, as someone who has been and still is shy around new people, is a pretty big deal.
And it feels good, it's like, Vanessa!
Oh my god.
What I think truly separates Jonathan from the rest of the group is how he is on the inside. Something I've noticed about Jonathan is that while he may be the loudest and the most extra in the room at all times, he is a little bit more on the quiet side when it comes to him talking about his own past and what he has dealt with. Being that he is technically the most flamboyant and breaks gender norms more than any of the others, it's fair to assume Jonathan has faced a good amount of bullying for being who he is. This is by no means me delegitimizing what the others have been through. Everyone has had a tough past, it's just that Jonathan has remained pretty silent about his. You get an answer for this silence in his Vulture conversation with Justin Theroux.
Oh yeah, I remember what it was. So essentially my friend's like really mad about this thing that happened, like this thing. Mm-hmm. And they can't stop talking about the thing. But I was like, if you got more into the solution of that than rehashing the problem.
Do we care about what the thing is or?
No, just the idea that like, you know, getting into the solution is cuter than me rehashing the problem, because like Eckhart Tolle talks about how like our brains and our bodies, like our bodies don't know the difference between like reality and a thought. So if I'm like replaying like the state of the world right now, and I'm not really like actively thinking about a solution, I'm just like, you know, titrating on the problem, and I'm just like over it and over it. Like, I think that just stresses me out.
Jonathan lives by the philosophy of rarely addressing the problem, or at least dwelling on it, and focusing completely on the solution and progress. I think this is especially important when we're talking about something like Queer Eye and self-improvement. When you look at the other members, they approach the contestants' flaws in a way that's like, okay, this is what's wrong, we need to get rid of it. Karamo will address every corner of a problem, Tan will make sure a graphic tee never sees the light of day again, Bobby will sometimes just straight up get rid of your furniture, and Anthony, oh my sweet honey bear Anthony, he will look in the fridge and go, what is going on here, this is very bad, and just throw shit out. What Jonathan does is take what is looked at as a flaw and builds off of it rather than destroying it. He embraces the fact that no matter who you are, you're beautiful. He truly lives by the Tim Gunn motto of making something work, not throwing something away. That is, unless we're talking about a bad skincare product, which in that case, honey, you gotta get that out of your life. Between creating a comfortable environment, doing his job the best, and living a progressive lifestyle, it's safe to say Jonathan is without a doubt the queen of Queer Eye. It's easy to look at Jonathan as a silly gay guy who can be funny and looks a little bit like Jesus, but I think beneath that is someone who genuinely cares about making the world a better place, and it can start with something as simple as a good haircut. When I first started watching Queer Eye and heard the corny reality show EDM music, I'll admit I was hesitant. But after plowing through both seasons, I can safely say it has been one of the better decisions in my TV viewing history. Queer Eye has made me look better, feel better, think better, all with just a few small tips. So seriously, give it a shot. You might just come out of it with a new avocado-related recipe. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. Before you head out, I want to say two things. One, we have merch now. We have a lovely shirt that says Pretentious on it with hearts and glitter, and we also have this incredible robot shirt that is incredibly wrinkly because I left it in the dryer for too long. It's a great shirt though, and we have tons of other options of cool designs that you can check out in the link in the description. I'd also like to give a quick thank you to this week's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is a great company because it's where you go if you want to take your thing and make it into a reality. Whether it be for a blog, an online store, or portfolio, Squarespace is a great place to go to make your own website and make it look good. They have a wide selection of award-winning designer templates that look super sleek, simple, and just really nice. They even have 24-hour customer service in case you get lost like myself, and it's really just a great place to go. If you use the other link in the description, squarespace.com/Karsten, you get 10% off of your first purchase. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to check out some of the merch, and also make sure to check out Squarespace, and I will see you guys in the next one.